Hey guys, I'm Eric Peterson, and I'm a men's dating and relationship coach for skillofattraction.com. And today's attraction tips video is called Choose Women Who Provide You Value. Now, as men, most of us go for any woman who we find attractive, or even for some, any woman who will give us a sliver of attention. Most guys will chase these women to the edge of the earth, bending over backwards, jumping through hoops, hoping that she'll like us. In many of those cases, what do these men get in return for all that they do for these women? Not much, if anything at all. Sure, she may flash a pretty smile and thank you, but is it done out of politeness or genuine appreciation? Can you even tell the difference? Some men come to me who are having problems with a girl, not really sure where they stand with her. It's actually a pretty big problem. And they'll rationalize that since she's responding to their text messages, that it's a good sign. I mean, it certainly could be a good sign, but it could also be that she's just being polite. The way I was raised, you acknowledge someone when they're talking to you. I remember when I was a kid, my dad would be talking to me while I was zoned out on the TV or something. And I heard every word he was saying, but I didn't acknowledge it. And he would just scream at me, "Answer me!" A typical kid thing, I suppose, but he really crammed it into my head that when someone is talking to you, you respond. My point being, is she just being nice or not rude, or does she have a genuine interest in you? These are the sorts of questions you need answered when investing in women. However, you can't just ask her, "Do you like me or am I just wasting my time?" Because the chances of you getting a straight answer is slim. For one thing, women don't want to hurt your feelings. They're typically emotionally sensitive creatures and they don't want to cause another person pain. So if you ask her something like that, whether or not she likes you and is attracted to you, she's probably going to tell you something like, "Well, let's just see where things go." Or if she feels that your relationship to her, whether platonic or romantic, is being threatened, she may even say something like, "Are you saying that you won't be my friend if I'm not into you like that?" Now, did any of those responses answer your question? No. In fact, you may even be more confused now than you were before. So what does the typical guy do? He continues to invest in her. Perhaps he invests even more, thinking that maybe he's not doing enough. And if he just does or says the right thing, he'll get his answer. However, he's most likely still not going to get the answer because she'll most likely continue to accept his attention and validation without giving anything in return. The best way to know whether or not you should continue to invest in a woman, whether she's a new girl in your life or she's a girl you've been with for years, is to determine if she brings value into your life and with relative enthusiasm. So in this attraction tips video, I'm going to be discussing why you must only choose women who provide you with value and only focus on those women. It may sound cold or harsh, but why would you want to invest in a woman, or anyone for that matter, who doesn't provide you with any value? But if you guys need my personal help and you're interested in some private coaching, please head over to my website at skillofattraction.com. Click on the coaching tab. There you'll see that I have several options for you to choose from. Now, for one thing, I have discontinued the email coaching, but I have added some new, more affordable options to the phone coaching for my North American clients, and I've also added Zoom coaching for my clients outside of North America. Many of you have been asking me to offer shorter calls, more affordable options, and of course, many of you in other countries have asked that I be more accessible for private one-on-one coaching. Well, I listen to your feedback, so keep it coming. And I'm also looking into a texting option, which some of you have also requested. And so just let me know how my new options are working out for you, and I'll announce when and if I add the texting option. And I'll post both the links to my contact page and my coaching page in the description down below. Now, as I just mentioned, many men waste so much of their time chasing a woman that has little interest in them and provide very little to no value into their lives. Then they get angry with women because they wasted all this time on them. But it's not really women's fault, per se. I mean, if a woman who you weren't all that interested in was coming to you and say, giving you head, screwing your brains out, cooking you meals, cleaning your place, and so on, and she got angry once she realized that you weren't that into her, I mean, would you feel at fault for that? I mean, you would probably feel that you weren't giving her any signals that you were interested, and she was just offering all the things that you liked. No strings attached, right? Well, that's how women often feel too when you're offering your time, attention, and validation and help. When you're the one it's happening to, yeah, you feel kind of shitty and taken advantage of. But if she weren't making herself available for dates or showing you any genuine interest, then it's really on you for not recognizing the signs. That's why understanding female attraction and what to look for is so important. Now, it's a completely different story if she's stringing you along, knowing that you like her, and throwing you little gestures of false hope. I mean, that's different, and she's doing that shit on purpose. However, you still need to pay attention to the signs so this sort of thing doesn't happen to you. It's easy to overlook certain things when you really like a girl, even more so when she's giving you all kinds of false hope. My point is, you shouldn't be providing women with attention and validation that they crave from you, unless they're providing you with real value. Now, I'm not saying that you should be keeping score, that you won't do a particular thing for her unless she's done something for you. I mean, that's pretty petty. However, you do want to be cognizant of the value or lack thereof that she's bringing into your life and at what consistency. Now, understand that women only choose you if she perceives you to bring a lot of value into her life. They don't choose men simply because the guy is hot like we choose women. I mean, yeah, they may for a one-night stand or just something completely sexual, but they won't get deeply involved with the guy unless he's providing value for her. So you shouldn't feel weird or guilty for sticking with only high-value women. Now, this is why you always want to be objective about the women whom you become deeply involved with. I mean, initially, most of a woman's value lies in her beauty and her sexuality. I know women hate to hear that, but it's just a fact. And of course, as you become more and more involved with her, more of her value outside her beauty and sexuality will begin to come out. You know, is she being loyal? Does she have integrity? Is she thoughtful and supportive? Does she have your back? Does she push you to be a better man? Is she a good communicator? I mean, those are just a few things that your average man would find highly valuable in a woman. But you all will have a different definition of what's valuable coming from a woman. I mean, maybe you want children. Is she in her childbearing years? Will she be a good mother and wife, a good homemaker? Or is she more of a career woman who's most likely going to end up being in competition with you, undermining you, trying to take control or take the lead in the relationship? Believe me, the last thing that you want is a woman who is always in competition with you. I mean, men and women in a relationship are meant to be a complement to each other, not compete with each other. Now, there are plenty of beautiful women out there and plenty of women who put out. They are not in short supply. But the beautiful ones who not only provide value to your life and lifestyle, but also whom you have a good connection with, are going to be rare. I mean, that's really the trifecta, right? Beauty, value, and connection. But is this why you, I mean, this is why you want to date around, so you could find these women. Sadly, most men take whatever they could get and fully commit to that because they have no other options. And oftentimes these women men settle for are not high quality women at all. And why is that? Because men have not built up their own value. Now, remember that women tend to date up in terms of sexual market value because they choose men who bring a lot of value into their lives. So they choose men who are typically a point or two above them or above their own sexual market value. So if you want a high quality woman, a beautiful woman, this means that you have to become a high value man first. Over the years, I've noticed that in most cases, people end up with a partner who is in a similar place in life. As an example, if you're lazy, overweight, have a low-paying job, don't really take good care of yourself, you're most likely going to end up with a woman who is similar in your sexual market value, and usually a little below your sexual market value. So in other words, you attract who you are. And actually, I did a video called this a few years back, You Attract Who You Are. You might want to check that out. So if you keep ending up with low value women, women who bring little to no value at all into your life, then it's a good time to really start taking an honest look at your own life. I mean, that's how I got into this. I've never really had issues with attracting women, but I couldn't keep them to save my life. And all my relationships were ending the same way. And for years, I just thought I had terrible luck. I mean, even my buddies would sarcastically say something like, Eric, you really know how to pick them. But at one point, I decided to figure out if it was me, and I was going to figure this all out. And it turned out that I was pretty needy, I was too nice, I was a people pleaser, I gained a bunch of weight at one point, and I was just skating by in life. And looking back, I was lucky to have the relationships that I did. I mean, it was really no wonder why women didn't stick around, even though I treated them very, very well. And people, they just don't like to be that honest with themselves, but it's necessary if you want quality relationships with attractive quality women. By just being more selective and objective with women, that you're already stepping up your game. By watching these videos and reading the books that I recommend, you're already above the average guy out there. And by doing the work, I mean, you're way ahead of your competition. But, you know, don't stop there. It's a lifelong journey with really no end. But regardless, don't settle just because you're getting laid and getting attention. I mean, honestly, women shouldn't settle either. It's really just a waste of your life. So choose women who bring value into your life. Sure, you could have fun with the attractive girls who don't bring you any value. Just don't commit to them. You'll regret it in the long run, and doing that will prevent you from meeting and dating the women who do have value. You'll just get lazy. And we tend to stop looking when we have a girl that's, you know, giving us attention and giving us sex. But it's a trap. So if you found this video helpful or any of my videos helpful, I'd really appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up and for you to share it with any of your friends and family. And I'd also really appreciate it if you hit the subscribe button down below and tick that little bell symbol next to it so you get real-time notifications of when I upload new videos. And in the description down below, not only will I have a link to both my contact page and my coaching page, but I also have a link to PayPal or my Bitcoin wallet address if you deem this video worthy of a donation. And if you scroll all the way down, I posted a few links on how you can start earning money today with crypto and stocks. Make your hard-earned money make you more money. I mean, that's really how you get rich. So that's it for this video. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Have a good one. Bye-bye.